No one wants to see your dangle dingle.
I think probably someone in the world would disagree with you.
Someone.
Someone somewhere.
Not here, not now.
Cross your legs, boo.
Have you ever realized how yelly Meg gets when there are penises involved? It's like anytime someone says the word penis or someone says the word moist.
Cross them!
Fine, I will cross my moist penis legs. Meg. From Innovation Park, it's After Hours. With Jordan Tracy and Mitch Strasser. Tonight on After Hours, match party with ESPN's Perry Champion and special guest, Ms. Steve Sloan. And now your host, Jordan Tracy.
Hey, everybody! Yes, how's it going? Sorry, our guy in the audience took down the applause sign and then put it back up and down. That's what happened. Mitch, how's it going today?
Yeah.
Great. Yeah. I'm glad to hear that you're, yeah.
It's the day after Valentine's Day.
Oh, yeah? You're so, looking real sensual right now.
Yeah, I didn't go to sleep till like 7:30 in this morning time, so.
A lady keeping you up?
No.
I thought you were going to have an excuse other than that, but okay, cool. So did you get that email today about the guy like responding to the PSU text?
Yeah, I thought that was great in like the worst way possible.
Yeah, he responded by saying, "How do I unsubscribe to these things?" But send it to everybody who has it. So that's probably like close to like 30,000 people who got this email.
It was like, not only do I want to say that I don't care about like sexual assaults that are happening, but I want literally everyone to know it was me.
That's exactly it. Yeah, that's going to be unfortunate. I wonder how many people will actually respond to him. So in the news this week, let's get it started. Arizona State student section has seemingly reinvented the free throw distraction, featuring characters such as a shark attack, the return of Elvis, twerking farm animals, my favorite. But this, by far, is the most successful distraction. Check it out. That is just absolutely disgusting. You know, that's probably not one of my sexier moments on After Hours. Yeah, that's... You attracted to that, Mitch? You looking at all that? All that bass?
No.
Fair enough.
Thanks, though.
Oh, sorry. Thought I'd help you out. So Kanye West rolled out his Yeezy Boost shoe line for Adidas on Thursday, but it was actually rudely interrupted by an old man saying, "I'm gonna let you finish, Kanye, but the New Balance are the best."
Old people dying is the basis of 95% of comedy.
Do you think like New Balance? Do you wear New Balance sneakers?
I actually did for a long time. My only shoes right now are like off-brand, but I wore New Balance for a pretty long time.
Yeah, there was a moment there in my life where I did wear those New Balance, and then apparently people were like, "Those are dad shoes," and then I cried and got me some Jordans for $400, and then went broke, of course. A new Android app called Hi There, which is a dating app for pot enthusiasts. The only problem is they can't find each other until we find themselves. Right? Yes, high dating. That's great. So there's this thing called the Fat Map. Everybody hear about this? The Fat Map. It's a comprehensive genetic map outlining the genes that lead to obesity. And it's been released by a team of scientists. It's the largest genetic blueprint of obesity ever. I actually just thought the Fat Map was a treasure map I created when I was a kid, pointing out where I hid things in my uncle's fat rolls. What do you think, Mitch?
So that's how Santa finds his way.
That's right.
Uncle's fat rolls?
What?
What?
It's his fat map.
Oh, sorry. That was unrelated to the Santa thing. All right, whatever.
It also turns out it's actually the Fat Map is not a map of Mississippi, as it turns out. It's not. Is Mississippi our fattest state? I feel like...
Probably. Somewhere in the South.
Definitely in the South. A lot of butter. A lot of butter down
Texas
there.
Has like 4 out of the top 10 fattest cities, I think.
Oh, I thought you were going to say Texas has the 4 of the top 5 fattest people ever in the world. And I was like, how do they do that statistic?
They weigh them.
Everybody.
I mean, like, I don't know how I can make a joke out of that, but that's just scientifically how they would do it.
They would weigh everybody and find the fattest person. Yep. Yeah. So starting in September, iPhone users will be able to use Apple Pay for some government transactions, including access to national parks and the IRS. Another change, tax refunds come with a free U2 album, just like iTunes, just put on your phone there. I feel, do they send it in the mail, or do they just give it to you? Yeah. I mean, that's another extra, what, $7.99 to your tax refund, I think? Is that how much U2 albums go for?
No one knows, because U2 is bad.
Can't say that. Bono got hurt. He got hurt. Can't be mean to him. Just the rest of them. So Jackie Robinson West was stripped of its Little League national title for gerrymandering its roster. And no one was more disappointed than their shortstop, gerrymander. Thank you very much, everybody. We'll be right back after this. We have a great show. Miss Steve Sloan's here. Woo! Open it. Welcome back, everybody.
Yeah.
We've had a wonderful show at this point. Like, a lot of crazy things just happened previous to what we're shooting right now. And you guys just have no idea what happened before then, except you're seeing it right now. So we have a great guest this week. Miss Steve Sloan is in the building. What is up? What is up? So I don't have to explain it. Why don't you explain what exactly you do?
Well, I am a drag queen.
Yes.
So, yes. And I go by the name of Cassandra Prophet, with the S's in my name are dollar signs.
Okay.
So I'm actually representing that with my earrings today.
Dollar signs.
Dollar signs. It's also my initials, Steve Sloan.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's clever.
Clever.
That is clever.
I do shows at the nightclub levels in State College, and sometimes in the Hub. Like, we have an annual student drag show put on by the LGBTA Resource Center and stuff. So,
cool.
Yeah, that's what I do.
How'd you come up with the name?
It came to me in a dream. That's all I have to say.
Oh, okay.
Well,
for legal reasons.
For legal reasons. Well. It actually comes from the myth of Cassandra, the Greek myth. Whenever she is given future sight by the gods, but no one believes her. So, like, I'm trying to, like, play on the words, like, prophet and, like, you know, like, seeing the future and, like, making money. So, like, you know, Cassandra Prophet. That's how I came up with that.
So do you use that type of, you know, the whole prophesizing and the myth of Cassandra in your shows?
Not really, but I kind of like the aesthetic of, like, a psychic sort of thing. So in my one number, I did Oblivion by Grimes, and I had, like, this gothic ensemble that was, like, I had these, like, big shades on, and whenever, the song's, like, kind of creepy, so whenever this, like, creepy part of the song came up, I, like, removed my sunglasses, and, like, I had blood all over my eyes, and it was kind of, like, scary. So, yeah, I'm into, like, the darker side of drag, I guess.
The dark side of drag. Behind the scenes and the dark side of drag.
Yes. I love to incorporate fake blood into my numbers. It's an awesome little way to just surprise your audience.
You surprise them with real blood, and then you really get them.
That's a great idea, but I don't think I'll ever do that. So.
This week, Cassandra Prophet will... sacrifice,
slaughter
a goat.
Yeah.
In the middle of the stage.
I should think about doing that one day, maybe.
I like it.
It's kind of like witchy, so.
I like it. I like it. So you guys just had a show.
We did.
At Levels.
We did, yeah.
How did I saw a couple of clips. How did it turn out?
Well, the audience turnout was not as big as I expected it to be, I wished it would have been more people. Like, our first show had so many people there, and it was just a blast. But, I mean, the show itself went really well. All of the performances were splendid, and I had a really fun time. So that's what really counts, I guess. Wish I would have made more tips, but...
That's actually what I wanted to get into. I saw in some of the videos that you actually, people were giving you money on stage. And I think you had, like, a bag.
I did,
And you were, like tucking it in
yes,
and everything.
I was.
So Yes, definitely yes. Tucking it in as quick as possible. So talk about the tips.
Well, tipping is not just a country or whatever. That's what we always say. And there's this really nice quote that a lot of drag queens use. It's not cheap to look this cheap. So we mostly just get paid from tips, but sometimes the venues will pay us some amount of money, mm-hmm. depending on the turnout of the crowd and stuff. So, I always make sure I have a tip bag on me whenever I'm performing, just in case someone, you know, wants to throw a 1 or a 10 or a 20 or a 100. But, you know, haven't gotten that last one yet. But we'll see.
Wait, so you've gotten 50s?
No, I've never had a 50 okay. either, but yeah. unfortunately. But I have had some fans throw like 10s and 20s in my direction before, oh. especially during my first show. A lot of people really liked that Oblivion number that I was saying. And I did Baby One More Time by Britney Spears. And that was a hit with the crowd. I think it was because it was like a throwback or whatever, but mm-hmm. yeah.
So what kind of practice goes into, so when you're preparing for a show, do you really do rehearsals and practice and stuff?
Well. A lot of it's just like self-preparation. I mean, like, I'll get the date for the show and then I'll like design my looks and like figure out what songs I'm gonna be doing. And then once I have like my general look designed, I'll like go to Goodwill and just try and find like pieces that kind of match the ensemble that I'm going for. And whenever I don't find what I need, I just hop on Amazon, get that 2-day shipping from Prime. You know how it is.
Amazon Prime.
Amazon Prime. I am a big supporter of that. So.
After hours, believe it or not, we don't have sponsors. you should hold this.
Okay.
This home used to be in the mug, and I was very distracted that I didn't have one.
Well, I don't know what to do with this. But
yeah, just have fun with it.
Okay.
So, speaking of mugs, what is your favorite beverage?
My favorite beverage is alcohol in any form. Am I allowed to say that?
Yeah. Woo!
I don't know.
After hours, after dark.
Let's yeah, after dark. I'm a bad child, so I like to drink.
I just lost my mic in that whole tie thing. I think we went a little too hard there.
If that's not an appropriate answer, then I like coffee. Coffee's nice.
We'll put the coffee, we'll edit out the alcohol and be like, I really like any kind of coffee. And we'll just edit that out real quick.
Okay, great, perfect. I like coffee. Black, always. So that's all I have to say about that.
That was a good question.
Anything else?
Yeah. I like it.
I do have a favorite mug, though.
Ooh.
It's this Disney, like, sort of idea thing all over this mug, and then it has the word Betty on top of it. I just thought that was really fun. And someone personalized a Disney mug, and,
and
now I have it.
Yeah. So screw you, Betty.
Yeah,
if you're
screw
watching.
You, Betty.
We took your mug, Betty.
I have your mug.
And
Betty.
You're not getting it back.
Miss Steve Sloan has your mug.
Yeah. Miss Steve Sloan.
That was unnecessary. I had a mug with a goat on it once.
That's cool.
Yeah.
I like to collect mugs that are just kind of eccentric because. I don't know. I like Goodwill, and they always have eccentric mugs.
Yeah. I actually, for Christmas, gave my mom a mug that says balls on it.
Oh, and that's nice.
Yeah, it's a robot skeleton from Craig Ferguson, and just says balls.
Yeah.
She appreciates it. It's her favorite mug now.
That's nice. Mm-hmm.
I like how we got a little off topic, but I like that, Mitch.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Makes things personal.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, you know. People aren't only who they are at work, and I think that's important to remember.
Mac, we should put that on that.
I don't know what that means.
Everybody is
okay.
Just...
Yeah.
What's that one? Okay, so we're going to go to break here, but Steve isn't going to leave because we're going to do something special here. So stay tuned right after this. Don't go away. Welcome back. Miss Steve Sloan is still here.
Hi.
And so, Steve, Well, we've dragified ourselves a little bit.
A little bit, just slightly.
My weave is...
in shambles.
It is the worst
thing. It's terrible. It's actually the worst thing I've ever seen.
You can kind of see my tracks.
A little bit.
Just like a little bit. Fraggle who dropped out of Fraggle school.
You know, I think you could actually pull that off. Like, yeah. Just as a normal hairstyle.
You could work that.
You could work that.
I'd make sure to never comb my hair for 3.5 years.
Yeah, absolutely.
So what we're going to do now is we're going to switch it up a little bit. Steve's going to show us a little bit of how it's done to Lady Gaga's Paparazzi. And then once we think we got the hang of it, Mitch and I will take it over. Yeah. So kick it! Steve Sloan, thank you very much! And we'll be right back after this, don't go away!
Find a resonant frequency in a lot of the stairwells around campus.
Really?
Yeah, it's fun. So if you have any musically inclined friends, have them take you around and show you. It's really cool.
Interesting. Like what places?
The stairwells in, oh gosh, what's the one that's right down from Willard? It's like a big long building.
Sackett.
Sackett, yeah.
Whoa! Yep. Geography up in here!
Yeah!
So we have a package for you. I don't know how to explain it. I honestly don't know what to call it.
Yeah.
I don't know what's going to be on your screen in a moment. I just, Mitch, do you have it? You're in it. I don't
yeah.
know.
Well, I'm not in it. I was the camera guy for it. It's really cool though. No, it's awesome. We had a collab with a big name in journalism. We got We got ESPN's Kerry Champion to come in and do like a Valentine's Day special with us, which was super fun. All cinematography, all this guy. So you're welcome. I guess was where I was going with that.
This is one of those moments where I'm so glad nobody watches this.
Wow.
I just mean like ESPN-wise.
So, Jordan...
like if Kerry Champion would see this, she'd be really offended.
Okay.
She'd be really upset.
Yeah, well, I don't know. Whatever, Artie Lang.
I got what you're going for.
Yeah, I think she's a beautiful lady and she's great and she was willing to do this special with us and then you're just like walking in and pooping all over it. So,
I am not pooping on Kerry Champion. I have not pooped on Kerry Champion.
The name of this package is Pooping on Kerry Champion. Enjoy.
Enjoy.
Hi, I'm ESPN's Kerry Champion. Today we're going to talk about Valentine's Day. I've been watching you a la 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 long. Welcome to PSNtv. Welcome to PSNtv. This mic looks like a British palace hat guy. Hey man, you want to be on a dating show? No? Okay, good answer. You want to do dating show? No? Good answer. Here's a condom. Yeah. Thank the Latinos for that one. Would you like to do a dating show?
Yeah. What do we have to do?
Do you like? Do you like the manly men's or the ladies?
Men.
Good answer. Here's a condom. I don't mean good answer in a homophobic way. I just mean the condom wouldn't be very useful otherwise. Moving on. Do you guys want to be on the dating show? Do you guys do a dating show? No? Hello, everyone. Would you like to do a dating show? Question one. Are you a fan of the ladies or the manly men? The dudes? Okay. Here's this. Yeah. I don't know what it is, but they gave me like 20 of them.
Can you open it up and you can see inside?
No. Do you like other fish? But I think it's a lesbian. Do you want to be on a dating show with the questions and stuff?
A dating show?
Yeah.
No, thank you.
Woo! What's your name?
Stan.
Stan. Stan gave me a card and he told me I'm beautiful. Good work.
Good work,
Stan. Take this condom. There you go.
Oh, awesome.
It's extra sensitive in case you cry after sex. When you give me candy and flowers, happy Valentine's Day. That's poor sentence structure. Do you like dudes?
Yes.
Have a condom. It's extra sensitive in case you like to cry after sex. Hi, how do you feel about velvet shoes?
I mean, they're okay.
Yeah, I think they're pretty dumb too. Congratulations, have a condom. And
yes,
if you
say,
yeah.
Gary, you have to hold the mic up when people are talking to you.
Dude, I think I should hold them up. Oh, is that what you said? What is your Valentine's date? What's it like to be multi-ethnic on Valentine's Day? Do you just like bone 24/7? Match made. Hey, how do you feel about Valentine's Day? You heard it here first, folks. Valentine's Day is a force field. Hello, would you like to do a dating show? It's Valentine's Day. Feelings?
Uncomfortable.
You heard it first. Today is President's Day. Do your tax returns.
Hey, that was the best open I've ever heard in my entire life. I liked it was warm, it was genuine, and I didn't try too hard. I liked it.
Yeah, it's a lot like Georgia.
Yeah, a lot like Georgia.
It's warm, it's genuine, really didn't try too hard, though.
Go sweet old Georgia. Welcome back, everybody. Hey. We had a wonderful show. We had Miss Steve Sloan, or Cassandra Prophet. That's her drag name. Mitch, what would your drag name be?
ESPN's Carrie Champion.
Yeah, it would be.
Yeah.
It would be. Yeah. I think that's your porn name. That the first name of your
It's your first pet and the street you lived on growing up. Which yeah. Mine is amazing.
What is it?
Clink Lutz.
Clink Lutz.
Yeah.
Mine's Blub Blub Hamilton. I'm a rather large porn star.
Fitting.
I feel yeah. like it'd be like a video of like me eating sexually. Yeah.
Have you ever known any porn stars?
Known personally?
Yeah.
No. Yeah. Can't say that I have. I mean, I feel like I know them sometimes.
Yeah, I don't know. A girl I went to high school with started doing porn after she graduated, but that kind of fell through.
I like where this is going.
Yeah.
No, let's talk about this.
She came back to town after it like didn't work out. You're like currently breaking the desk.
Did I break
yeah.
the desk?
She came back to town and like I offered she could sleep on my pull-out couch, but the concept seemed completely foreign to her.
yeah, that makes sense. Mm-hmm.
I just there's a lot I didn't understand. I tried to ask her about it. Like, I was curious about, like, the birth control situation, but she wasn't having any of it.
Thanks for that, Mitch.
Thought I had to include some sensuality in my very sensual outfit today.
Undoing the tie.
Yeah.
Feeling fly without the tie.
You're welcome, whatever subset of people find me sexually attractive. That one's for you.
I'm trying to think what demographic that would be that watches the show. And I can't find one. Can't find one.
Yeah. It's a sad existence.
Yeah, it is. It is. So thanks for that.
You're welcome.
I like that little tale. Little tall tale.
Yeah.
So we had a great show. I want to thank you all for joining us. And hopefully we will see you back next week. Bye-bye.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day. Love you.